Good day, this is Terry DeFazio, and you're watching Dial It Up. Today on our show, we have Carrie Patterson and Ellen Bowen from the Employee Assistance Program. Good to have you on. I know Ellen from the OCCA. Now, how long have you been gone from that program?
Well, I've been with InvestEAP since 2012, so probably 2011 or so since I've worked for OCCA. Yeah.
Okay. And how long have you been involved with EAP?
I go back to 1999.
Okay. and just briefly go over what it is the EAP program provides and what it does.
An employee assistance program is an employee benefit that an organization purchases for their employees. It covers both the employee and all the members of their household, whether they're relatives or not. And it's a bundle of services that includes short-term counseling, resource, and referral information such as legal, financial specialties. We provide work-life support where families are balancing children and or elder care. Any of the stresses that a person is going to experience during their working life that may impede their productivity or their ability to be present, affect turnover, these costs to businesses that an EAP can provide support to those employees or their family to help them stay focused and be productive.
Okay, so who basically is eligible for this program?
InvestEAP is a Vermont-based employee assistance program. We are available to any business, nonprofit, organization in the state. We have our EAP counselors statewide that we can provide services for. At present, we cover all state employees, municipal employees, school districts, many hospitals, mental health facilities, private businesses, all over the state.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and currently how many are involved in your program?
At this point, amazingly, we're covering, when you count employees and family members, 100,000 Vermonters. One in six Vermonters have InvestEAP at their workplace.
So does this help people get jobs, find jobs?
No, this is not an employment service. This is a benefit for people that are already employed.
Oh, okay.
Already employed, so at their workplace, this is an additional benefit to, say, their health insurance or short-term disability, where these services become available to them at their workplace for them and their families.
Okay. Now, Ellen, you have a couple of specific duties that you perform. Can you tell us about those?
I do. I have, I'm an account associate, and what that means is I go around to all the schools in my particular district, and I cover Essex North, North Country, Orleans Central, and Orleans Southwest Supervisory Unions. So in each school, twice a year, I go around and I do a 15-20 minute orientation as to what are your EAP benefits and how can you use them. And that's for all school employees, even part-time. So we want them to know what these benefits are so that they can use them and get the most out of the support in their workplace. So I do that for schools. I also do that for towns under the Vermont Leagues of Cities and Towns.
So
they have the passive insurance, which is property and casualty intermunicipal fund insurance through the towns, which almost every town has. They also, through their insurance, have the Invest EAP benefits. So I do the same thing. I go around to all the towns that have 10 or more employees and do this orientation. If they have less employees, I usually send them the RAC cards and some information. And then we also do supervisory trainings for anyone that's in a position of leadership, whether they be principals or management in the towns. And that training helps them to see a very specific part of the Invest EAP program, which is if they have an employee under them that's experiencing any type of employee problems, performance issues, they can get specific support through EAP as a manager to help this employee work through whatever those issues are. So I do both of those orientations for the towns and the schools. And then I am involved in something called Farm First, which this is also a program for farms in the state of Vermont. So I cover a very small portion of the farms, again, giving them this orientation if they need to know about what their employee assistance program benefits are through Farm First program. And then lastly, I do something called the Life Resources Coordinator.
Okay.
And that is, as Carrie had mentioned, certain agencies or businesses will buy this service so that they can have an on-site workplace consultant, which is myself, to provide, you know, several hours a week of assistance with any variety of daily life challenges, resource coordination, and I also make referrals to counseling if that is deemed needed to give them further assistance. But it's just nice to know that they can just stop in my office and get some help, sit down and chat about whatever they're dealing with, or if they need, you know, childcare support, I can do all the legwork for them and then give them the information that they need so they can further deal with whatever issue they're dealing with. And that, again, that also includes any household members. It's not just the employee of the particular agency I work for.
Okay. Now, what seem to be some of the overriding issues that you have to bump into every, or that you tend to bump into almost every day or every other day, or what are some of them?
Legal is definitely a big issue. We have people that are going through separation, divorces, or maybe, you know, as Carrie mentioned, elder care, looking at living wills, estates, things along those lines, because EAP has a support with legal and financial. And financial is another really big one. You know, people are absolutely struggling financially today. Mm-hmm. And so we make referrals for debt consolidation, budgeting support, just sitting down and helping them work through things such as that, you know, budgets and bills and how to make those ends meet. School loans are another big piece of their financial problems. So I would definitely say that those are probably some of the biggest issues. And then just people needing the ongoing counseling. It is, EAP provides what we call short-term solution-focused counseling. It's not long-term mental health, but it really has benefited many people that I've worked with to get that support of additional counseling.
So does your agency interlock with other agencies? And if so, which agencies do you tend to, or other departments do you tend to work with?
Invest EAP is an interesting collaboration. We live in the state of Vermont in vocational rehabilitation, mm-hmm. and we partner with VABR, the Vermont Association for Business and okay. Industry and Rehabilitation. So those disability connections really help us with any of the employees that might have disability issues. We can seamlessly connect those them with those services. But Invest EAP really is a freestanding service for all Vermont businesses and organizations. And it's interesting, Ellen speaking to the life resource piece, which is those services right at the business, where normally to access your EAP service, you would have to go to the office of the EAP counselor. So that life resource product is really great for a business who wants to bring that professional support service right on site, so that, and then they allow their employees time during their shift to go see the resource coordinator, which is just makes everything so much easier to access and just meet those needs right there. And Terry, it's interesting to think about why an organization would consider an EAP. And you know, Fortune 500 companies long ago recognized the benefits of EAP. Mm-hmm. Vermont businesses tend to be smaller. Mm-hmm. We're not thousands of employees, but that doesn't mean that our Vermont businesses don't have the same issues of distractibility, reduced productivity because of stress or personal problems. Vermont businesses have the cost of turnover, of behavioral issues that take supervisory time. those costs Vermont businesses are incurring every day, every workday.
Mm-hmm.
And the only mechanism available in the marketplace to help a business stop them from incurring those costs and addressing the reasons for unexplained absences, for problems that cause conflict with coworkers, for the productivity things. That an EAP is the only service that can get to the source of the things that cause that those costs. And the research has shown that the return on investment for every dollar a business or organization spends for an EAP program, they're going to get $3 to $17 return in avoiding those costs in, again, turnover, productivity, absenteeism. So it's a really powerful fiscal responsible way to address those costs that, unfortunately, Vermont businesses are incurring just like everybody else.
Yeah, that seems to be universal. I mean, a business is a business, and it's going to have a certain amount of cost it's going to incur, and of course, employee absenteeism or other issues, health issues. I mean, that's going to involve everyone. And it's nice to hear that this is a program that will address that. Now, one thing that was mentioned that caught my ear was the legal part. Mm. Do you have to deal with a lot of lawyers?
No, the way.
Well, that's good.
And that's the beauty of the EAP program as a bundle of professionals. EAP, our staff, our counselors are the clinical side. But for the legal and financial, we partner with a service called CLC. And they are professionals. There's a network of attorneys and financial people. So an employee who is an Invest EAP member calls our 800 number. I need a legal service. So we're going to make that referral to them. What that gets them is a half-hour free consult with an attorney, a local Vermont attorney, to figure out, based on whatever their situation is, are there just some forms they need to fill out? Do they need to kind of navigate a certain system? Do they need an attorney to pursue some legal situation? But that half-hour free consult is huge when you're facing the legal system, which is huge. You need special information. So the EAP provides that half-hour free consult. And then if the member employee needs to retain a lawyer in our network, they'll get a 25% discount on the fee.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the legal service component.
So what sort of legal issues come up?
Boy, interesting. You speak to why do Vermonters access their EAP? And it's been 17 years now, and in various capacities, I have monitored usage.
Mm-hmm.
And when I started in 1999, the two major reasons across the board, didn't matter whether you were a town or a mental health agency or a manufacturer or a hospital, the two reasons people were calling EAP and accessing their service is they were stressed at home, family relationship, and they were stressed at work.
Mm-hmm.
So you think about that. Everywhere they went, these folks were stressed. And then about the early 2000s, mid-2000s, we saw a third issue creep in, and that was mental health issues.
Mm-hmm.
People were self-identifying depression, anxiety, and serious mental health things. And in the last 10 years, mental health issues has, again, varying industries, has surpassed workplace and family relationships. So those three. Mental health, family relationship, and workplace issues are the three main reasons why Vermonters access their EAP program.
And with mental health, I would imagine part of that, with that comes substance abuse problems?
Absolutely, absolutely. Mm. And unfortunately, very few people will self-report substance abuse. But the beauty of the EAP is that, say I come into EAP for maybe a financial problem, even calling EAP for the referral to the financial problem, our EAP specialist is going to have a conversation with that employee and encourage that employee even to come in to discuss, well, how did that employee get into this financial problem?
Yeah.
And in those secondary issues of substance abuse, and again, depression, anxiety, those things tend to surface because of that hands-on face-to-face work that we do.
And I would bet that's an overriding issue that might get underreported, but you guys obviously know this is a fact of life.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
And the managers and people in leadership know that something is going on with that employee, so when they call and take part of that supervisory consultation that we had mentioned, when it is then determined that the employee has this other issue, you know, they just see as a manager, oh, they're not showing up on time, or, you know, they're leaving early, they seem frazzled, they don't have the reasons, maybe, you know, doctor's note, so to speak, to come in. And then they refer them to an EAP counselor. That issue can get solved privately, and then the supervisor, you know, may never know that that was the actual issue, but the performance at work hopefully gets better, improves, and so through the manager, they actually got the EAP service to deal with this underlying problem.
Mm-hmm. This leads me to another question, but and actually it goes a little further, but if a person if it turns out a person has a substance abuse issue or even a mental health issue, do you guys handle that, or do you hand that off to another agency that specializes in that?
In terms of the substance abuse issue, several, referrals may need to be made, mm-hmm. Whether the person wants, residential treatment, outpatient treatment.
Yes, okay.
EAP is going to make that connection. We're not going to do the substance abuse treatment in-house.
Right,
but,
okay.
But the reason why EAP is a great on-ramp is because we're in the business. We know who does good work out there. Mm-hmm. And our network of affiliate clinicians understand these issues. We vetted them. So that referral is going to be a soft transfer. We're going to make sure it's a good fit. We're going to provide the ongoing support. And in terms of mental health, as Ellen said, EAP does a solution focus. So when a member comes into EAP, sees the counselor, and the first thing that is going to be looked for, the counselor is going to figure out, well, what does this person need? What is the issue at hand? And maybe it's grief and loss, and they just need a little help to kind of get through that process. And it's going to be a few visits. That's going to stay with EAP. But what we know, if someone presents with a serious mental health problem, that requires 12 to 15 visits with a clinician. Mm-hmm. That's not what EAP does. Mm-hmm. We're going to very quickly make the referral within the person's insurance network to people we know do good work and make sure it's a good fit. So we're going to refer that out for the longer term counseling.
Yeah, the reason I ask that is because an employee that I worked for many, many, many years ago, I left in 1998, but if you had a substance abuse issue, if you went to them and said, I've got an issue, they could not refuse you service. Mm-hmm. And a few guys and girls that I knew at the time, they were given in-house residential substance abuse treatment. I think only one person abused it so bad that after three strikes, they finally fired him. But if they requested assistance, the employer was required to honor that.
Right, right.
And I know one person actually went to rehab twice, and I know a couple of other people went to rehab once. Is that sort of the same sort of an idea that we're talking about with your agency?
Well, again, the employee would come to EAP, and we're going to get them what they need. Now, if it was a residential treatment situation, with the employee's permission, it's, again, EAP is confidential.
Right.
Nothing gets back to the workplace without the employee's written permission.
Mm-hmm.
So with the employee's permission, then, the EAP counselor would work with the employer to manage the absence from work for the inpatient. So EAP, you're going to come to EAP, we're going to get you what you need.
Mm-hmm.
The employer is not going to know anything about that unless the employee asks us and gives us permission to work with their employer.
Yeah, well, as far as substance abuse is concerned, though I know it's probably still governed by 42 CFR Part 2, which basically says even if you're an agency or a counselor, you can't disclose information without permission and all that other stuff, unless there's certain criteria has to do with physical property loss, or you're going to go kill somebody, something
like
that.
Right, mandatory reporters.
Yes.
EAP are mandatory reporters.
Yeah. Yeah.
What sort of financial issues do you guys run into with employees?
You want to speak to life resources?
Again, I would say the majority is just everyday budgeting. That for people, they're working 2-3 jobs. I mean, we think that those days were only during the recession that was started back in 08, but it's still happening,
of
certainly
course.
For many employees, and trying to juggle all that and still have family time and meet their bills is huge. So, you know, we really work on that. But for other people, you know, some are getting ready to retire. And that's, you know, a great phase of life, and EAP can help them not only with that transition, but also what to do with their retirement funds and all of those things that they've been accruing through work. You know, that we can set them up with someone who is completely objective, is not there to sell them anything, and can really assist them. The other nice thing to bring out about EAP, speaking of retirement, or possibly if someone was to lose their job or choose to move on, you get EAP services for 90 days post-employment, and that's to help people through those transitions in life. And most people aren't aware that they can still call their EAP for up to those 90 days after they've left their employment that had an the Invest EAP service.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You made me think of something. It was about maybe 10 years ago when a certain president that I won't mention, he was bragging about how they'd created 1 million new jobs. And a buddy of mine looked at me and said, yeah, I got 3 of them.
Right.
yeah.
That
and
is
it
a realism.
It ties in exactly what you guys are saying, that some people are working 2 and 3 jobs just to make ends meet in there, and they might not even be doing that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They're still not.
Right. And with the EAP, that's another thing that an employee could come to EAP to again, strategize about how they're using their time and what they're doing vocationally. So absolutely. And if there's any disabilities, we're going to connect them right with the Vilk Rehab Services to, again, provide all the services possible to help that Vermonter to thrive. This is EAP often lives in wellness programs within organizations.
Mm-hmm.
So this is, again, the wellness of the business, the people they hire. We want to be doing good work, but also the wellness of individuals. And families. These folks are our neighbors. These are the people that just live near us. And Invest EAP is a nonprofit organization. We work very hard internally with all of our accounts to make sure that every employee really understands what their EAP can do for them. We promote it. We want people to use it. There's no disincentive for people not to use it. The opposite. We really want people to know about it. And try to say, if you wonder if EAP can help, give us a call.
Yeah, and the nice thing is we have a really comprehensive website, www.investeap.org, and on that website people can do self-assessments as to maybe substance abuse, mental health. They can look up legal and financial, so people that have EAP can log into that website and get tutorials, videos. There's over 1,200 legal forms that they can download that are state specific. I mean, there's a lot on the website as well as for managers and HR people on how to use EAP in those positions. So anyone that's wondering if EAP can help, there's the website too, and they can click on Need Assistance and sign up. I mean, again, they have to have Invest EAP through their workplace, but they can sign up for a counselor to call them.
Right.
So that's a great resource. And also, our critical incident debriefing is a wonderful benefit that we want to be sure to bring out. You know, unfortunately, there are critical incidences that happened in businesses and schools and different things. And should that happen, should there be a loss of, you know, a beloved colleague or a child in a school system or, you know, some other tragic event, EAP can come and do some on-site support.
Which just happened recently. The assistant fire chief of a local community tragically died in a tractor rollover, 58 years old.
Oh, okay.
It was a municipality, so EAP, I just heard this morning, was there last night to provide support to the first responders who had to go and free the gentleman who was their friend.
Yeah.
So EAP was in that community last night supporting those first responders. Which is another, so Invest EAP is an umbrella EAP program. We have Life Resources, which is the coordinator on site. We also have on-site EAP. We have EAP Farm First, which is EAP for farmers.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have EAP First, which is a new specialized program for first responders, fire, police, state police. which has brought together very specialized clinical expertise for that community.
So part of what you do that's extremely important is you'll help pick up the pieces of a tragedy.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Because the whole PTSD clinically, managing that critical incident so that those involved do not get into a cycle of PTSD related to that.
How much interaction do you guys have with legislators?
None.
You have none?
None.
I suppose that's a good thing.
Yeah.
That's handled by somebody else, I take it?
The executive director on occasion is called to speak to the legislature or certain committees or the head of human services or the other agencies, but the rest of us fortunately don't.
that's probably a very good thing, because once you get entangled, ensnared in that bureaucracy, it can be something else. Is there anything else you ladies would like to add? Because I'm finding that this has been very informative for me, because I knew a little bit about it, but not much.
I would like to, you spoke to, the legislature. InvestEAP has been successful. We are self-supporting the businesses and organizations that purchase this service, which is very inexpensive, less than $3 per employee per month. So if you had 100 employees, that's $3,000 a year for this full range of service. So we're not using state funds. Mm-hmm. This is a viable program. We're not using taxpayer money. The service is being provided. And what I really love about InvestEAP is we're a small state, we're small businesses, but the Vermonters that are served by InvestEAP have as good an EAP as the folks that work for IBM or Coca-Cola or any fancy company anywhere in the country. We're there serving our neighbors.
That's good. Ellen, anything you'd like to add?
No, I just appreciate the opportunity to let people know that, you know, it is a wonderful program and they should check in with their employer to see if they have it. And if they don't, ask if they can get it, because it really is probably the best return on investment that an agency is going to make for their employees, so that they can be healthy and productive both in the workplace and at home.
Can you give us your contact information one more time? If somebody was interested in learning more about this program?
I wrote down the number. The website, of course, investeap.org, but if anybody had wanted to call, that is the number of the person that they could speak with, Jen Hayback at...
It's 802-863-7502.
Great.
Very good. I want to thank you for this opportunity to have you on. And down the road, I think we should probably do it again.
Absolutely. Our pleasure.
Okay. Thank you very much. This is Terry DeFazio for Dial It Up. Saying we hope you enjoyed the show and you guys have a good day. Bye now.